Geometry is around us all the time. It's so intricately involved in our day-to-day life that we don't even notice it. How, you may ask? Imagine that we're walking in a straight line for 1 kilometer. After that, we turn left and walk 1 kilometer in this direction. Then again, we turn left and walk 1 kilometer in this direction. Now for the last time, we turn left and walk 1 kilometer. We would find that we are at the same place we started from. If we trace our route, we would find that we walked in a square-shaped route. This was only one example. Geometry is hidden in natural patterns too. Have you noticed the seeds in a sunflower? If you look closely, they form a spiral-shaped design. Do you know any other examples where you notice a spiral pattern? I know one, spiral galaxies. These are types of galaxies that have a spiral pattern similar to our sunflower seeds. So we see that geometry is involved in things as small as sunflower seeds to things as big as galaxies. Don't you think it would be fun to study these geometrical shapes? We have a very long history with the knowledge of geometry. From ancient times, people were aware of geometry and used it in their day-to-day life. Let's take an example of ancient Egypt. Long ago, the people of ancient Egypt faced a problem every year. The problem was that the Nile River used to flood each year. And whenever it flooded, it used to destroy the boundaries of land near the banks of the river. This used to put the landowners in a problem. After the flood, the boundaries of lands would dissolve away. So nobody would know which part of the land belonged to whom, and this would result in confusion. As this was an annual problem, they came up with a system of measuring land and redistributing it to the respective owners after the flood. This system of measuring was one of the factors that gave birth to the word geometry, which we study today. The Indus Valley Civilization around the year 3000 BCE also made use of geometry. Their cities were well planned, houses had different types of rooms, well planned roads, and a good drainage system. This was not possible if they did not know the use of geometry. Basically, geometry was being used in many parts of the world throughout the period. The word geometry itself comes from the combination of Greek words geo, meaning land or earth, and metrine, meaning measurement. So geometry means the measurement of earth. The geometry we study on paper today was actually conceived as a solution for day-to-day problems in the ancient world. The ancient Egyptians also used geometry in construction, designing granaries, and making the pyramids. So, all the existing knowledge about geometry was brought together in a form of books by Euclid. Euclid was a Greek mathematician who used to teach mathematics in the city of Alexandria in Egypt. He was the first person to collect all the work done on geometry and put it together in books called Elements. His books contain definitions, axioms, postulates, and proofs that we can use to prove things further ahead in complex geometry. We will try to cover some important definitions, axioms, and postulates from his books that will help us in solving and proving theorems to make our understanding of geometry clearer. So in the next lesson, we will learn about some of the basic definitions in geometry that Euclid put in his book named Elements.